Hey guys, do you need to play a super romantic song for that special summon? Or maybe you have a wedding gig coming up? Don't worry, I've got you back. We've got a song tutorial here for Ed Sheeran's Perfect, which is such a beautiful and romantic song. The good news is there are only 4 chords in this song. So we need a G, an E minor, a C, and a D. That's it. So if you can play this, 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 and this, you can play this song. So in this tutorial, I'm going to be providing you with a free lead sheet. So you're gonna see the right hand melody notated, and then you're also gonna see chord names above that. So you can download this for yourself, so you can practice with it, you can use it as a guide. And in this lesson, I'm gonna give you some tips for how you can use this lead sheet to learn the song and then create your own improvisations so that you can make a performance that is uniquely yours. So to begin, the first thing you need to know is simply how to play a broken chord, a broken 4-note chord. So in this song, we've got G, B, D, G, D, B. And that's gonna repeat. And then we're going to head to E minor and do the exact same thing. And then C, same thing. And then D, same thing. So practice that. If you can do that, you've got the left hand nailed for the whole song. That's really all that needs to happen. So that's your left hand part. The tricky part now is just getting that right hand sorted out. So let's take a look. We're gonna start with D, E, G, G. Sounds like this together. I just want you to see because it's so pretty. Right? So, how do you do that? D, E, G, G, B, A, G, B, and then A, B, 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 A, G. I should have held that G, please forgive me. And then we're gonna walk up G, A, B, D. And the great news, once you've figured that out, the verses just kind of use that in different slight variations throughout the song, but that's the main bulk of it. So to put it together, you're gonna play these first 3 notes by themselves. And then together here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's how it goes together. And then we can carry on. This part's a little different. We go B, A, G. So together. And then to D. Familiar here. G, A, B, A. And that's the verse. So the sort of pre-chorus repeats this D, and I don't play anything in my left hand here, I just go. And then I jump back in. Fell in love. So we've got D, 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 E, B, A, B, B, B. And then we go stepping down B, 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 and then stepping down C, step down to B, and then G, D, B, C, B, A, and then that repeats. So hands together. We were just kids when we fell in love. It works perfectly with these broken chords. And that repeats. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own. That's a pre-chorus. So really there's only one more step left and you've got the song for the most part. And that's the chorus and the outro. So let's take a look. The chorus, again, I take a break with my left hand for this. Baby, I don't do anything here. I'm gonna have it ready and we'll land together on the I. So it goes like this. Baby, I'm. So the right hand, we've gotten from the G to a high G. We've got an F sharp because we're in the key of G, E, F sharp, B. Now we're gonna go from D down here to D up here, and then walk down C, B, A, G, G, and then repeat. G, F sharp, E, And then it changes slightly, G, B, A, G. And then B, D, 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 E, B, A, G. And then B, D, so here's a broken chord. F sharp, E, F sharp, B, G, A, B, D, C, D. And then we've got C, B, A, C, B, G, A, B, A, G. That's an A, G, G. And then I'll show you the little bit in a second because we gotta put the tenths together first. So, baby, I'm. So it's just those broken chords. You'll notice sometimes my hands are kind of overlapping, and that's okay. I just sort of piece out with one of the hands and let the other one take over, and that's because I like how it sounds when the left hand's a bit higher. You can take it lower. And another thing you should note is if that left hand feels complicated, you can just do like shells of chords. So from the chorus, so measure 35, instead of going like this, you just get the C shape. Right, that totally works. You can even slow it down. See, there's ways you can simplify it. It's just to make it simple. Simplify to make simple. What an idea. Okay, so then the last little chunk we need to look at here is this sort of climb down, which will take you back into repeating those verse and chorus. So on measure 50, we've got a D and a B with a G, and then a D and an A. And then a D and a G with an E in the left, and then a D and an F sharp with a D, and then a C and an E with a C, and then an A and an F sharp. And that's what carries us back into the verse. And my favorite way to play this is to break them up, so fill the chord space in. So pretty. And then you just go back and repeat the verse, and then you repeat the chorus. And then there's sort of this little instrumental section, which you've got all the skills now that we've sort of gone through the foundations of the song to figure that little part out. And then the song ends kind of right where we just left off here with this. D and a G. So there you go. So if you would like a more in-depth approach to learning the song, you can head on over to pianote.com. All of our song tutorials have step-by-step breakdowns, so we break this down into even more bite-sized pieces. We provide you with a practice-along feature, which isolates little sections, gives you notation to follow along with, and kind of loops it for you. We also have backing tracks for you to play along with on the members site as well. So there's some really great perks to heading on over there to learn your songs. So if you'd like to do that, I'd love to see you there. Otherwise, enjoy learning the song here. Comment below to let me know what you think and have fun. See ya!